Hey students, so today we are going to learn a very interesting and most important topic of engineering mathematics, which is called as curve tracing. So what is curve tracing? So guys, definitely it is different than curve plotting. So in the low standards or in the schools, you must have learned to plot a curve by taking x and y coordinates. So you used to find out the x and y coordinate for the given curve, and then by plotting all the points on the graph paper and connecting the points, you are getting the curve. So guys, that is called as curve plotting. Now, curve tracing or curve sketching means understanding the characteristic of the curve, understanding the properties of the curve, and based on the properties and characteristic, understanding the nature or the shape of the curve. So basically, curve tracing gives us the general idea about the shape of the curve, how that curve will look like, where that curve will intersect x and y axis, and by using that, it becomes very easier to solve the problems of area, then the problems of mass of lamina, then the problems based on finding the length of the curve. So there are many applications. So basically, using curve tracing, we are going to understand the characteristic of the curves. Based on the characteristics, we are going to understand the shape of the curve or the general idea of the shape of the curve, and we are going to use that curve to solve the multiple numericals. So in engineering mathematics, we have the application like mass of lamina, we have application like area, then we have the rectification, where we generally require the shape of the curve. And let me tell you guys, there are many type of curves. So starting from the Cartesian curves, we have the parametric curves, we have the polar curves. So it becomes very difficult to understand the shape of each and every curve, or to by heart the shape of each and every curve. And I'll say that it is not recommended that you should memorize or you should by heart the shape of the curve, because if we have the curve tracing, then by learning few properties or the characteristic of the curves, it is very easy to draw the curve and to draw the shape or the exact shape of the curve. So guys, as I told you that there are three types of curves. Okay, so Cartesian curves, parametric curves, and the polar curves. So here we learn the different characteristics of the curves. So first of all, I write down the definition of curve tracing. It is sketching of the curve by understanding different characteristics of curve. So this is the definition, and as I told you that there are three types of curves. So the first curve, that is the Cartesian curve, the second type of curve tracing or the second type of curve that we are gonna learn is parametric curves, and the last step that we are going to learn is polar curves. So guys, we'll see the tracing of the curves of these three types. So out of that, let's start with the first type, that is the Cartesian curves. So whenever we want to draw the shape of the curve, which is given in Cartesian form. Now, how to identify that the given curve is in Cartesian form? So it's very easy. If the given curve is in the form of x and y, or if the equation of the curve contains the variable x and y, then we call such type of curves as Cartesian curves. For parametric curves, we say that if the equation given like this, that is x equal to f of t and y equal to g of t. It means x and y are function of t. So such type of curves are called as parametric curves, and polar curves are identified by r and theta. So any equation of the curve which is given in the form of, or which is given in the variables r and theta, we call such curves as a polar curves. So these are the three different type of curves which we will be tracing. So out of that, let's start with the Cartesian curves. So whenever curve is given in form of x and y, we call it as Cartesian curve. So guys, to trace the Cartesian curve, we have to learn few characteristics of the curve. So there are seven characteristics that we are gonna learn in Cartesian curves, and I've already listed it down for you. So here we have the seven characteristics. So here you can see that I have marked star for the transformation. So guys, basically transformation is such a type of characteristic which we always observe in the curve when the curve is given, and after that we apply the six characteristics. So basically transformation is a kind of adjustment where we understand whether the given curve is given by shift of origin or whether that curve belongs to some basic curve. So through transformation we derive the basic curve, and for that basic curve we apply these six characteristics, then we draw the shape, and again by transformation we locate that curve at the proper position. So the first characteristics that we will be doing for Cartesian curves is symmetry. Then we'll see about the intersection with coordinate axis. So guys, let me tell you about one characteristic, symmetry. So basically we know the meaning of symmetry is anything. Let's say if there are two parts, and if those two parts are same, then we call that these two parts are symmetric. For example, human body. If we cut the human body in exactly two parts, then we say that yes, both parts are same. It means the human body is symmetrical about y-axis. So similarly, in terms of curves, we can find whether that given curve is symmetric about x-axis. So let's say this is the x-axis. So if the curve is symmetric about x-axis, it means the part above x-axis and the part below x-axis will look similar. Next, we can check the symmetry about y-axis for y equal to x-line and for the opposite quadrant. So where we can see there that whether the curve is symmetric in first and third quadrant, at the same time in second and fourth quadrant. So that is the first property. Then intersection with coordinate axis. Here we'll say whether our curve is intersecting x and y axis or not. If it is intersecting, then we'll find out the point of intersection where it is intersecting the curve, where it is intersecting the coordinate axis. Next, the region where curve does not exist. So guys, this is very important property, because here we come to know the region where our curve does not exist or it will never lie. It means by finding that region, we also come to know where the curve will lie. So this is the property number three. Next, tangents at origin. So guys, here we are gonna see whether our curve has any tangent at origin or not. So there can be multiple tangents as well. Then we are gonna find out the node, the cusp and the isolated points for these tangents at origin. And then we'll see the asymptote and critical points. So asymptote is basically a straight line, and we are gonna see the three types of asymptote, like horizontal, vertical and the oblique. I'll tell you how to find those asymptote. And in the critical points, we are gonna see when our f dash of x is zero or does not exist. So guys, basically these are the six properties. We will learn each and every property in detail in further videos. So keep watching the videos. I am sure that you understood the basic concept of curve tracing and what we are gonna do in the further videos. So keep watching the videos. We'll meet in the next video where we'll see the details about each and every characteristics, and we are gonna trace the lots of curves. So thank you very much. Keep watching the videos. Thanks.